This guzzle is called The Cobra. Oh, beloved Mayhair, it is not that you do not trust me, but rather there is something lacking. Sorry. Let me start over. Oh, beloved Mayhair, it is not that you do not trust me, but rather there is something lacking in me. I do not realize that you trust me, and this is the reason why I can't catch hold of your daiman. What should I say if anyone asks me about your attitude towards me? Isn't it that you are most slippery, and the more I try to follow you, the more you change your ways? What a life of repentance I have been leading since you dropped your physical body. The remembrance of my unpleasant behavior towards you is digging my grave. If you call the day as night, you are justified because you are the truth. But if I call the day as night, it is my ignorance and I am not justified. What happened when you hammered and hammered and hammered my reasoning intellect continuously for years? I realize the fact that you are beyond reason, and the reason exists only in the domain of illusion. What happens when my desires and thoughts make me fall into the pit? I don't remain in the pit, but gain strength by taking your name, and rise out of the pit and become free from those thoughts and desires. Oh, Bao, how ignorant you are, and how the illusion has made you a toy in its hand. The cobra of the false self has become stronger and stronger in you because you go on feeding him, not knowing that it is a cobra. Jay Baba.
Courage. I feel thirsty now for only your wine. Every breath of my mind is restless. Come, come, O Mayhair, come today. Manifest, manifest, O Mayhair, manifest today. Oh, Bao, what type of intoxication is this? I am suffering, and I crave for more. Oh, Lord, make me drink the wine of love. Make me drink love.
And it's called The World is Dancing to the Signs of Your Fingers. Oh, Mayhair, I have no place in this world without you. Bestow death and end this loss, lost life of pain. Oh, beloved, I realize you are helpless to come near me. Your coming will only be when I go away. I made you famous throughout the world and stayed with you, so why do you now feel ashamed to show your face? My madness on your path invites the world's scorn. I swear you are compassionate, but the world laughs at you. I have been clothed of different colors that I cannot shed, only you can easily pull my arms from the sleeves. Oh, Mayhair, everything is in your hands. You are truly matchless. Don't forget the world is dancing every moment to the signs of your fingers. Oh, Bao, what should I do? How long can I remain patient? The beloved has gone away, leaving only excuses for coming back soon. Jay Baba.
This is called The Fire Burning Within Me. Oh, Mayhair, when the tears were shining on my cheeks like pearls, people would express their sympathy towards me. But as soon as the tears turned into fire and there was no sign of pain left to be expressed, no one paid any attention to me. Oh, beloved, my agony of life expressed through water attracted sympathy of even my enemies. But now, as the fire is burning within me and there is no outward expression, no one cares for me, thinking I am mad. O people of the world, you laugh at me, thinking I am crazy, uncultured, ignorant, and insensible, and that you have no intelligence to cope with the world. And you are right. But I tell you that you too have to pass through such a life one day. Oh, friends, do not feel pity, thinking that I am inactive, lazy, and good for nothing for the world, because you don't know how active my beloved is within me in order to make my false self inactive. Oh, social workers, no doubt you do good work in order to help others, but you feed your false self and make it very strong. I starve my false self in love for my beloved, and in this way, the world is served by me without knowing about it. Oh, brothers and sisters, you don't know what happens when you love the beloved wholeheartedly and lead a dedicated life to serve his cause. You serve the whole world without knowing it, and this help to the world is lasting. Oh, Bao, people laugh at you when you can't answer their questions about what you do. But they will laugh more, and they will think that you are crazy if you tell them that you are very busy making preparations for your death. Jay Baba.
And I have been asked to say something about Dhoni. How did it begin? It was in the year 1925, Meher Baba was at Mehrabad. And it was 10th November. And one day, people came to Baba with a request that because it did not rain during rainy season, now one crop they had lost. Now another crop, winter crop, it is there and still there is no rain. Please do something. Baba said, don't worry. You go back. They had come at night, at about 10 o'clock. And then at 11 o'clock, Baba went near the roadside and lighted the dhuni. It rained and rained for 48 hours. And people were very happy. Then in 1926, again, the anniversary of Dhoni was celebrated. And again it rained. And then afterwards, Baba went to Toka, another place. And the ashram was by the side of the bank of the river. And there was no rain. And they came to know that when you approach Meher Baba, of course it rains. So they all came. They all came with a request that Baba, there is no rain and our crop is failing. And Baba said, all right, I will see, you go back. It started raining and raining and raining. The river was flooded. And they all came back again. Baba, now please stop. And the rain was stopped. Then afterwards, Toka. And then afterwards, Baba started going here and there. No dhuni. Up to 12th December 1941. Dhuni was not lighted. But Baba was so busy at that time in seclusion. Seclusion, where he was keeping seclusion in his own tomb. he would remain in seclusion there. So many times Baba was in seclusion there. And Baba said that now Dhuni should be lighted. You take me there at Lower Mehrabad, but no one should see me going there. So, of course, that they brought the bed sheets and this and that covered from all four sides and took Baba at Lower Mehrabad. And Lower Mehrabad, there was also covering all over so that people may not see Baba. And Baba said about the war. The war, I have arranged everything. Everything is arranged for war, just like here in Pardhuni, you have brought fuel, you have brought also the butter, and you have got beige box. What does it need? Just to put the matchstick, just put it, and the fire will take place. Same thing. I have made all arrangements are made for the war. And now the war may break any time. Be careful. So then of course Dhuni was not lighted, but then there was one person, his name was Pleader. And Baba looked at him and he said, Pleader would get God realization. And when Baba said that Pleader would get God realization, everyone was looking at Baba, those who were with Baba. And Baba looked at them and Baba said, you all will get God realization. Everyone was very happy. First Pleader thought that he was the only person who would get God realization. But then Baba said everyone would get God realization. And then afterwards, for the war, the Dhuni was lighted. Dhuni was lighted, and then afterwards Baba said that Dhuni should be lighted every month on 12th. Every month on 12th, and of course it should not be stopped. So in this way, of course, the Dhuni started, but again on 12th of January, when Baba had met Upasani Maharaj, and Upasani Maharaj dropped his physical body. So in memory of Upasani Maharaj, on 12th of January, Baba lighted the Dhuni. And lighted the Dhuni, and he said that Dhuni will not stop. What is there in Dhuni? You just put one thing as sacrifice. Just do it. And everyone did. And Baba says, continue this Dhuni every month on 12th. So at Mehrabad, if you go there, so you will find that Dhuni is lighted every month on 12th. Then afterwards, the war broke out. War broke out and different things happened. Of course, I need not, otherwise it would take a very long time. And then, of course, our who is there. Jivan Mukta. He would say, why do you take so much time? Where is that Jivan Mukta? Because of his head, I could not see you. And he looked like you. So Jivan Mukta, he is very anxious about this dhuni because he knows why it is lighted. So then afterwards, Padri was the only one who would be there at Mehrabad. So he continued the dhuni till the end. And he would light. Afterwards also, the dhuni is lighted. Today, dhuni would be lighted there and you all would go. But one thing I observed, and what was that? That you take silence. Silence, but I could not understand what type of silence is this. This is quite new type of silence. I have seen, but just they go, if they had to say something to someone, but that is not silence. Silence means no expression from the mouth. But you express through mouth very slowly. But you do that. Where is my mummy, Christine? She is expert in that. When previously she was in LA, so she would take everyone for dhuni and she would just see. Still you do? Don't do that. Because when, otherwise don't keep silence. Why do you observe silence? You say that observe silence. And you yourself do that, no good. In Mehran, of course, no good, never do that. Otherwise, don't announce that you all observe silence.
Actually, we don't even try it at
Mehran. It is very close.
Yeah.
Anyway, it is not close here. So now, tomorrow, of course, give the report who just did this. So then afterwards, of course, Baba would be here and there in different places. He would just move and the must work. He started his must work and always he would be just like he would be in Hyderabad. The Mandli would be there. And few Mandli members he would take and he would go. Day and night continuously for 15 days, 20 days. He would be out. Then again he would come back after say 15, 20 days. Then again he would go. The must you see in wayfarers, they are up to 1948 and 49, of course, two supplements Dr. Duncan had made. And that was up to 49. Afterwards, nothing about the must. So wayfarers, of course, it does not have the full account. But then I had collected, because I was there, I would go to Baba, with Baba. And then, of course, I had written one book. and it disappeared. Disappeared means it was given to the priest, Syria priest, and it disappeared. Disappeared. Totally, and I don't know how did it happen. There was another thing also I had written, and that was the play, The Ancient One. And that Ancient One, that play, it was performed in Baba's presence in Saroj Cinema at Ahmednagar. And Baba took all the manli, men and women, there to observe that play. It was staged so nicely, but also it disappeared. It disappeared. So it happens. But now I come to the Dhuni. So in 1954, that declaration meeting, at that time, the Westerners have gone there for 3 weeks. And they were there at Upper Mehrabad. And Baba said, Dhuni should be lighted so that they may be present there. Then, of course, they were present, and Dhuni, Baba was present there for the Dhuni. 55, again, this is important thing. So Baba said, 55, Sahwas program was going on, and one group was there, and that was Telugu group. Where is Ravi? His group. Yes. Though he was not born, but his group was there. So Baba said that Dhuni, it is lighted. Today we would light the Dhuni, but before that, I just give one example. What you should throw, anything which you like very much, you throw in the Dhuni, but never eat it again. And Baba gave example of Dr. Nilkant Godse, one of the manli. Baba says that here is Nilu. He likes one sweet very much, sweet product, milk product, very sweet. He likes it very much. And on the contrary, I don't give money to anyone, but I give 30 rupees per month to him to eat that milk product. It's called Basundi. But if I ask him to throw in the Dhuni without any hesitation, of course he would do it. And when Dr. Nilu heard this, and what Baba did, yes, Baba, if you ask me, I will throw it. So Baba said, you have not two desires. So many desires are there. And if you just throw any desire in the Dhuni, lust, anger, but it is not so easy, little by little. So don't do such a thing that which you cannot do. Otherwise people would, I just throw my lust. Yes. I throw my anger. Baba made it very, very clear. Lust, anger. First thing, when you come in creation and pass through the planes, at that time the impressions are not there, you don't experience. But lust and anger, they come first on sixth plane. So they remain up to sixth plane. Though you don't put into action, as soon as you lose this gross consciousness and enter into subtle plane. So what happens? Then of course you cannot put anything in through physical deeds. But thoughts, they come. They come. But they remain there. Bodily, of course, you don't do anything. You just forget. Because your consciousness is not there, gross consciousness. So gross action you cannot perform. But people who just do this, different ways they adopt, and that is not proper. It should be free from the mind. And therefore, always think over that I must not do such a thing which may create trouble for me. Just put anything which you like very much. Just like now, my mummy likes ice cream. So she says, no, I like ice cream, I throw. It is easy for them. Of course, she remembers sometimes when she sees the ice cream. But no, she does not touch. So at that time, Baba made it very, very clear. It was in the year 1955. Now what happened? There were persons. Afterwards, the dinner was there. And when dinner was served, somebody, no, I threw this in the dhuni, don't give me. Then another one says, I threw this. What? How to serve them? So we are facing difficulty that now today Baba said this, and they are the persons, of course, different things they have thrown. And they say that, no, I don't eat this, I don't eat that. I have thrown in the dhuni. So just like yesterday, I gave the example of Dr. Nilu, how he would look after the patients, so many patients. But then they would always take anything from Mehrabad as prasad. Now what happened? Some sick persons, so for them, of course, special food would be made. But they would eat special food, and also they would be in the dining hall eating. And Dr. Nilu, he was just moving here and there, and they would look at Dr. Nilu. And Dr. Nilu would say, continue, continue, eat, eat. But then they would feel bad that they are doing this. But they said that this is Baba's prasad, and that's why we are taking it. So they would not stop. They would eat Baba's prasad. So this dhuni, of course, it is such a thing. Though it is symbolic, but when you do wholeheartedly, not mechanically, of course it has the effect. And Baba had made it very clear that his seat will be there for 1200 years. 1200 years his seat will be there. Wherever you light the dhuni, know well that he is there. His seat is there. And therefore, when you throw the stick, be careful. Don't put lust, don't put anger, because then, of course, you cannot observe it. If you can observe, it is a very good thing. But when you cannot observe, then, of course, it is very difficult.
Babaji, when there's a duty every month on the
don't do that. Don't go to that that extent. When you throw anything, now not only food, but there are certain things which you like in the world. You want to see something, so say, I would not see.
For your entire life.
Entire life. Yes. It is very easy to find out the things. And Jivan Mukta, he is not, he is Jivan Mukta. That means he is perfect. So he does not need to throw a stick. But if he does, then see that he is doing for you all. Yes, for you all. So this is about the dhuni. We continue dhuni there at Mehrabad. And and it is good that now you have that dhuni, you light, and it is a good thing at least you remember the beloved. Yes. No, don't like, never do that. Which you don't like, of course, no. Because.
Habits, let's say I tend to do something that I don't like about myself.
Whatever. Whatever, so. No, don't do that. Don't do that, just a small thing. If you eat something, or if you like certain things, so just say that, I throw the dhuni. So I will not do it again. Now today the subject was given to me, and that was why Baba observes silence. Why did he observe silence? And of course, we also could not understand about Baba's silence. Really speaking, silence can be known when your mind becomes silent. So it is the medium of his universal work. That Baba observed silence. And now how he started. Before observing the silence, when he was in Bombay, so there also for a few days, for a week, he observed silence. When he came to Mehrabad, so then of course again for a week or 5 days or 3 days, he would observe silence. But then afterwards, Baba told the Manli that I am observing silence for 1 year. 1 year, and then I would not speak. So Baba gave duty to everyone, what everyone should do. And that, of course, nobody could understand that silence. So what happened that before observing the silence, for 1 year he had said, and he went to the post office building. Post office building, it was just near the railway line. At the time of army, it was post office, one room. So Baba went there and something happened there. And Baba says, no, this date of course not suitable. What happened that Gulmai, Adi's mother, she was cleaning. And cleaning, she climbed up on the chair and then of course she was cleaning and she fell down. Baba says, this is not a good sign. So then Baba on 9th July 1925. 10th July, next day, of course, he observed silence. But he said that on 10th July, I would observe silence for 1 year. 1 year, and then what happened, that this Gulmai fell down. So first thing, of course, the different date which he had given, he did not observe that day. But 9th July at night, Baba went, met with the Mandi and gave different instructions. Instructions he gave, and then first he went to the women Mandi, then he went to men Mandi. So there was one temporary building for the Mandi, and temporary also for women Mandi. Only that post office room, one room was there, and other all temporary thing. So then, of course, Baba gave instruction to everyone, and then he said, remember this. If you are bitten by a snake, I am not going to help you. Be careful about the snakes. So Baba said this, and Baba went to, he was going to the jhopadi to sleep. That hut at Lower Mehrabad, and Padri came out to piddle, and he saw the snake. So he killed. He killed it, and Baba came back. I said, remember this. Everyone should come out with a flashlight, should not come like this in the dark. I will not save you from snake bite. This was the last words Baba gave. Next day, when he was, people saw him, Mandi, Baba was silent. He had already taken upon the silence. And what was that? It was the medium for his work. Silence, it is not that if you just observe silence, in order to obey his instruction, you are observing silence every year. But this his silence, it was for his universal work. So first he was using, first day he did not use anything. He had already given instructions, and but Baba would, he was very, very active. He was very active, so he could not sit quietly. He would just go here and there. He would just inspect the work, but nothing, no medium to say out, to give instructions. So then Baba would take up newspapers, and he would find out the words, and he would just put his fingers, and it would take a long time. So our Vishnu, one of the Mandi, he went to Ahmednagar and got the alphabet board made. So alphabet board, Baba was using that alphabet board, and it was very easy. He was so swift, just like this he would go, and he would do that alphabet board. But for 1 year, after observing the silence, he was writing. At that time he wrote that book. After completing the book, then of course, then he stopped writing, and then this alphabet board he started using. It went on up to 1954, the declaration meeting. And in the declaration meeting on 30th September 1954, Baba declared that he would not use alphabet board. He would throw alphabet board. And then, of course, Baba said that I would also drop my body up to April 1955. I will drop my body, a strange disease. I will face the strange disease. And of course, I would not use the alphabet board, and 3/4 of the world's of the world would be destroyed. Destruction. And nobody should write to me, and nobody should come to see me. And it was such a blow that people started, and then he started embracing each one. So they were just weeping and weeping. And then the same day they had to return. So while weeping, they left Mehrabad. And no writing. But at that time, 7th October, Baba had given the date. From 7th October onwards, he would not use alphabet board. And he would not see anyone after 7th October. So they thought that. And after 7th October 1954, that he would not, he would throw the alphabet board and he would be in seclusion. Now people thought that 1 week is there. So many letters Baba received. And in each letter, that Baba, you are going to drop your body. And of course, this 3/4 of the world would be destroyed. We would not be able to see you again. And you have stopped correspondence, and also you are not meeting us. And in one day, Baba gave the reply of all the letters which were received, because same content. And what was the reply? When I am going to be in seclusion and I would not see you, don't worry. This external approach I am just stopping. But I am just bringing you closer and closer to me. Externally, of course, I will be away from you. But internally, you will be very close. And therefore, don't worry about this. I am always with you, but you will feel that I am close to you. How this instruction given in 1954, how useful these instructions are, that though physically he is not there, but internally, of course, he is thousands of closer than your very breath with everyone. He cannot forget anyone. He cannot ignore anyone. Avatar or Christ, a prophet, Rasul, he is the one. He is always there in the form of ancient one. And same ancient one comes age after age. So do not forget that Baba, of course, he is not physically present. He is present and active. And that is the real thing. So he will never be absent. Never be absent. You keep him, you think that he is absent, but he is present all the time. And one day you will experience that he is always present. There is no past, no future. There is only present, eternal present. So then he lives in eternal present. And that present is such present that you cannot imagine. Just a moment, you say present, I am in present, but just a moment and it becomes past. It becomes past. So to remain in present all the time, you have to lose your mind. Unless you lose your mind, the present, of course, you cannot experience. So why he has observed silence? Silence, I tell you, his silence is quite different silence. Baba said that he would break his silence, but he did not break his silence. So he did not. Now what he will do, because he is not in body, he is always present. And he, all the time he knows everything and he remains active. So active he always remains, but 100 years after dropping the body, it takes 100 years for his universal manifestation. Afterwards, he will remain active, but not for 20 degrees. Why? Why he will not? Oh, Baba, of course, Baba is not there. So why not to go to anyone, of course, who are Swami or perfect master or saint? So he is thinking about it, that why not to go? Did you go to anyone? Huh? You did?
Yes. Oh, 5 of them. Thank you, then Baba Maya Maharaj, Prasad Maharaj, Madhavi, this one, and the perfect master.
What? Baba, I'm guilty. Yes, you're right. No. Perfect master, of course, 5 perfect master, if you went, it is all right. It is all right.
There was no more.
No more. What he did, that here, of course, when I wrote Lord Meher, first volume, so according to Baba's instruction, I wrote the life of 5 perfect masters. And that first volume, of course, he buys, and not one copy, but I don't know how many copies he purchased and went to India. Went to India and he went to Tajuddin Baba's tomb. And he presented one book to the committee, the board. To the board, and they were Tajuddin Baba? In America, of course, red carpet for him. Red carpet, good food and this, and he enjoyed whatever. And at the same time, they gave him what? Turbans and this and everything.
Shawl.
Yes. So he enjoys like this. Now, why I'm telling you that this enjoyment is all right. Nothing that he did not demand anything. They themselves, of course, paid so much respect. And why I am telling you this, that the time has come when if you go to any village of Andhra, Ravi, any village, Baba lover, any place, big place, city, or any small villages, you will be respected like anything. You will be respected like anything. And for whom? Because of him. Because of him. So, this silence, of course, Baba has given only once, suppose I heard him speak. And what happened? It was 30th of January 1969. That was the only day Baba was in complete rest from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Complete rest. Every day, of course, spasm. He would not be able to take any rest. And then that day, from 7 to 9, complete rest. And then Baba asked me to sit there on the chair. You must have seen the chair in the Mandli hall, in Baba's room. So every day, of course, I would just hold his legs so that he may not get spasm. But spasm, 6 Mandli members during daytime, but the spasm would come. Spasm would come one after another. And he would say that I feel as if I am breaking my bones. You have no idea. This is in 1954. Of course, he had said that strange disease. Nobody could make out what was it. What was it that he was getting spasm after spasm? So he did not even say at that time when he was suffering tremendously, infinitely. So, but that 7 to 9 he took rest and I was sitting there, but I would see different things before my eyes. And what was that? We are taking Baba's body to Mehrabad. Taking so many people are there. And again I would just think that Baba is now taking rest after a long time. And why these thoughts are coming? Why these thoughts are coming? Different thoughts at that time, that we are taking Baba's body and then people have come, they come crying and they would see Baba there in his own samadhi and they would come weeping and they would come out smiling. I would see there and why, I was just thinking, why these thoughts? And then of course after 9 o'clock, again the spasm started, and then I was holding his body, sitting near him, and then of course at 10 o'clock Baba said, remember this, I am not this body. The sign, remember this, I am not this body. 10 o'clock. 11 o'clock. Again, Baba says, remember this. But this time, yaad rakh. Yaad rakh. That very feeble voice, yaad rakh. And I am not this body. That was the sign. Third time, remember this, I am not this body. Only once. And I could not say that Baba remember, Baba broke his silence. He did not break his silence. His silence, it is so powerful, the whole world will be changed. The awakening will come. Awakening will be come, everyone will be conscious towards God. You will be awake. Awakening. Awakening will be there. So then, of course, I did not tell anyone. And because I did not believe in that, that Baba broke his silence. But after many years, when I went to Pune hospital, where is Freeman? Where is he? Whenever I call him, he is not here. Where did you go?
Outside, fresh air.
Fresh air?
Yes.
Here, these people, they are sitting here, so they don't need fresh air. They are sitting here. I just called you when I was in Lex, and you would get 2 hours break. Do you remember?
Yes.
Where will you go?
German bakery.
German bakery, and then the disciples of Osho, Rajneesh, they would come there and he would give lecture to them about Meher Baba. And what would happen? They would come to me. So they would come to me. I was in hospital at the time, and German bakery every day, and he would give lecture to them that who is Meher Baba. So they were very interested, so they would come. And one day, of course, vocal cord does not work. So he tried and tried. So many times he gave the dates that he would break his silence. But he could not break because the vocal cord, after 7 years, vocal cord does not work. So vocal cord does not work. So he said to me, and I said, that how do you say that vocal cord? Who is he? And why he was observing silence? You know the reason? Why he was observing silence? For his universal work. So universal work, unless that work is completed, the awakening people get. When he breaks his silence, there will be awakening. And then I could understand why Baba said, Yadrak, remember this. Afterwards, of course, in hospital when I was there, so different things would happen. And then our Shiva, he also came to the hospital. And hospital, and then of course, he would take dictation whatever I would see at night, what would happen to me. And one day, this free man, what happened, you tell.
Well, I guess he had sent her a lot of medication. I was on night duty. And actually, he was writing to Don Stevens that day. and so he just started talking about take down, you know, in his sleep. No, I don't think he said, yeah, maybe he was
actually first night when it happened, so he was sleeping and he got up and he started ticking down. Next day in the morning when I got up, I said, just write something. And of course, he said, I took down something last night. What is that? He read out the same thing which I was telling. Yes. The same thing he wrote down. And now people say that awakening, it is just illusory thing. So many things are coming out of it that he is just a psychological problem in my mind. So one psychoanalyst was also appointed to examine me. But good that psychoanalyst could not come means the train she was coming, so there was accident. And then she could not come, and then when she came, afterwards she did not ask any question. I asked her, what are your questions? She did not. On the contrary, she went to India. India, she would go to Baba's Samadhi every day, and then she would come to my office, and then she would tell me her own experiences in the Samadhi. Then last year, it so happened that I received a letter from Don that there will be public discussion in Oceanic. Public discussion, and Oceanic is the place Pete Townsend gives that only to me for 2 days. Only for 2 days, and there should not be any other thing. Just my talk, not public discussion. So then I wrote him back saying that it is not, whatever public discussion I don't like. In spirituality, there is no discussion, no argument, no explanation. Spirituality is spirituality. And how to discuss this? But still, if you want, I would go to the center. So you send those people who want to ask questions, and I will reply. But then in Oceanic, two persons came, and when I saw, then I invited question. But they did not ask any question. In the center, only two or three, not more than that, because they don't mix with inner group. His inner circle is there. So they don't mix with anyone. So of course they did not ask. But what happens? He has taken the group to India. I was in Devon at that time. And when he came from the airport, he was taken direct to hospital. Direct to hospital. Then when I came back from Devon, so he had come back. So he had come back, and then I went to see him. So he was locking the door from outside. He was coming to the center because I had phoned that I would see you. So he was coming to the center, but then no public discussion. So I tell you, this spirituality is such that there is no discussion. One has to keep observe silence. So far, spirituality is concerned. Now I come here, and also I invite questions. Why questions? Because I know that whatever questions you would ask, not intellectual, but to know about him more and more. So such questions are appreciated, but not that questions which has no just philosophical. This is not spirituality, is not philosophy. Philosophy is that subject which makes the simple thing complicated. So don't feel confused. Don't make anything complicated. Complicated, no. Just for Baba, if you ask anything, how he would live, where he had gone, what he would do, what was the must work, you want some information about him, such questions are, of course, they are invited. But if you ask philosophical question, then of course that is not necessary for spirituality. Don't show your intellect. Intellect is such that you have to get rid of it. It is not that because you are very intelligent person, there was one perfect master. And there was one person, he would write letters every day to the master, and master would reply. It went on and on for 2 years. And the disciples, they got very, very much angry. Master, people come and see you. This man never comes to you. And he just goes on writing letters every day and you reply. So master says, all right, today I will go and see him. I will go. If he does not come, I will go. So he goes along with his disciples. He reached there where he was living. And he said, just tell him that I have come to see him. So one disciple went to tell him that the master has come to see you. And he says, without looking at him, he just said, yes, call him. And all the letters, of course, he collected, put on the table. And the master goes. He does not say, please sit down, nothing. Oh, master, this question I sent to you, and how sweet reply you have given. For 2 hours, the letters. And the master said, all right, now I am going. I had come to see you, but you did not look at me. So at least, of course, look at me. And as soon as he looked at him, he started weeping and weeping and weeping continuously. Master, forgive. All my questions are no more. Because he got the love of the master, then where is the room for any question? So Baba's silence is that silence which makes us silent. And how we will become silent? You must get rid of all desires, wants, temptations, attachment. So we must try for that, and one day the time will come, one day awakening, you will know. You have not to just accept him, who is that, and read this or read that. Be never the words of truth, never put them into action. Just read and just show the intellect that yes, I understood this, I understood that, but understanding, of course, has no substance. It should be the feeling. It should touch the heart. So we have to put his words into action. The deeds, the thoughts, the speech. Bring Baba in that. And that is the real thing. And if you do that, then of course, one day you will realize who Meher Baba is. Now Meher Baba, next time when he comes down, he will not remain as Meher Baba. Different name will be there, but the same ancient one. The same ancient one comes age after age, but this is a certain thing that when he manifests universally at that time, because he breaks his silence, that will be the breaking of his silence, that means the awakening of the people to the humanity. And that, of course, he is going to do. And then we will know what is silence. We will know, not through words or explanations and this and that, it has no meaning. Because silence was the medium of his work. Every time when he has come, I don't know whether you know or not, but he observes silence for some days, a few days. Every time when he comes down on earth, he keeps silence for some days. But this time, because it was the medium of his work, continuous silence, of course, he was observing. And that silence will go on and on. He has given this tongue for us, and we can talk. If you ask two negris, just dance and sing, he is very happy. He said to in Chicago, when I was there, so there is one Richie Goldman. So Richie Goldman, he had taken divorce. So he announces before the Baba lovers, he is going to marry 7 times. This Tony Grace, infinite grace, he is going to divorce 7 times. Now he himself is doing. So today I have taken promise, you are all the witnesses, now no more. No more. Huh?
Why did you have to tell
him? After you?
Yes, I know. Now they all know.
No, this joke is not there. I am serious about it.
I know you are.
No more. No more. No. You said to Richie Goldman that he would have 7. So again he married just now.
And he did have 7.
She is from Chicago. Do you know that Richie Goldman got married?
Yes.
One Tibetan girl.
Oh, Richie. Okay.
Yes. So of course he saw her there and arranged, and then he would tell me about that visa for her. So I would write about that visa she would get, let her come to me. But she got the visa and she went to Chicago, and now he got married. So this is 4th time, but you, no more.
Promise.
Yes. Wow. Before others.
Promise.
Because, you know, here we are talking about Baba's silence. What is silence means all our desires should become silent. Means should be wiped out. And we are just, we allow the desire to speak. So then, what? One more? Who is one more?
I have none in mind.
Huh?
I don't think about that yet.
No, no. You just tell me.
I have none.
None, so one more you say?
In the future someday, maybe. One more. Not
except. Whether he should be allowed. All right, so no more. You all are witnesses now. So silence, this is the meaning of the silence, I'm telling you. Silence, so you should not do such a thing. So how can you observe silence? You just say observe silence. We are observing silence. But silence, we have to make our desires silent. And you will see what happens when Baba's universal manifestation will be there. So it is not that the world will go on. But whatever is undesirable, all undesirable things will be out of you. Out of you. What is necessary, it will remain there. Good impressions, bad impressions, we just see. But only those impressions which are in response to his whim, which makes the progress of consciousness, that is necessary. Undesirable, the desires which make you away from that, not in response to the whim, then of course you should not. You should not. But there are certain things. If I explain all this, very, very difficult, the things which are not necessary for you to do, it becomes necessary for her to do. Because these sanskaric complications, they are such that we cannot decide. One who does not know cannot decide anything. The bad sanskaras, which you say they are bad sanskaras, yes, outwardly it is bad, but those sanskaras, they may be in exchange of someone, so then you do that. So whatever happens, when you do that, then of course you are free from sanskaras, of those sanskaras. So how can you make it out? How can you say that you don't see that, don't do that, do this? So only thing, we have to depend upon him. And depend upon him. And when we depend upon him, then of course, whatever we have to do, just have repentance prayer. Ask him that now, whether we have done this, whether this is right or wrong, we don't know. Please give us proper understanding at least. So pray for that. Whatever you do, good, bad, for all, because good is binding, bad is binding. And therefore, never think about this. And that's why I say that don't think that I am a bad person and I am this and I am that. This is nothing but the modesty. It has no meaning. you don't become strong. You don't become brave. You have to fight. Fight with your own desires. They should not be there. And for that purpose, he has said, just remember me, follow my wish. And when Dhuni is there, in Dhuni, he would just throw these three women whom he has divorced. He will do that. Yes. Yes, he will do that. Now, what to say?
Why do you think we'll be here? In what form might we be here in 64 years? Some of us are a little old for that in this body.
No, but 64, that cleaning is going on. Cleaning is going on. He is very, very active. What he is doing? He is whatever he has collected from you, he has started cleaning. Those who have not come to him, but he has already collected from them. Those who do not know, those who have not heard about him, but he has collected. And now he has started cleaning. So this will go on. It is not that you will just remain like this. Of course, you will not experience anything. I am telling you, whatever happens, of course, you will not experience cleaning, and still you will be held. You will not know what he has done, but ultimately you will come to know what he has done for you. When the awakening will be there, then you will come to know. Otherwise, suppose experience, always I say that Mandali members are potatoes, nothing, because he has veiled, and then of course we don't know anything. What he is doing through me and to other Mandali members, no one has any idea. Circle is such that 122, two appendix, so 10 circles are there, in each circle 12, plus, but in first circle 12 plus 2, that is 2 Baba has given already, and that is Bani and Mehra. So Bani has already told that she would come back again and become perfect master. The rest, of course, they do not know nothing. So many Mandali members, of course, they did not know anything. Not that they had any experience, nothing, because willed. But this is definite. During this period of 100 years, suppose they come back. So they come back, but they must get realization within this period, 100 years. So one birth, or second birth, third, at the most third birth, but not more than that. And they will get, and then of course he will. He keeps the veil, so that they don't know. Through them he works. Through them he works. And what work he is doing, nobody knows. Now I just come and talk. Only thick talk I know what I am telling. And sometimes I also don't know, I forget after that. What I said, I forget. So nobody knows. But at the time, I'm just like Gustaji. When he dropped his body, he was from the beginning with Baba. And when he died in 1957, so what happened? We were in Bombay. Baba would always take him with him. Always Gustaji would be with Baba. In 1952, Baba came to America. And he brought him. He was observing silence. And he was using the gestures. So Sarosh and Adi, both were there. So, and Baba met with an accident. So they would eat outside in the restaurant. So they told Gustaji, Gustaji, you are coming with us in the restaurant and you just show your fingers. That is not good. Now tell us what you are going to eat. So accordingly, we will place the order. So Gustaji, what Gustaji said? Ice cream. Ice cream for 4.5 months. Nothing he ate but ice cream. 4.5 months. So when Baba was going to Bombay, first time in the evening, Baba would call Gustaji. He would call Gustaji and Gustaji was silent and he was silent. But Gustaji himself would just make this sign, that is soda. So Baba says, yes, give. So he would give the glass. Baba would just sip and he would give to Gustaji and he would drink. He would feel very happy. When he would come in the morning, so he, at the time, Gustaji would sit near Baba on the chair. And Baba would ask me to bring a plate. So I would bring a plate and Baba would say that important letter I told you. He gave instruction to write the letter, the points, everything. Go and write. So I would go to my room. And Gustaji would give sweets to Gustaji. And Gustaji would eat. He would not pay attention to any other thing. Only the sweets. And then, what happened? After 3 minutes, Baba would clap. So first I could not understand because other Mandali members were there. So then Eres says, bhau, bhau. So then I came. So one little piece of sweet fell down. Baba said, clean it, otherwise ants would come. So I would clean. Go back. That is a very important letter. Just finish it. Again I will go and I would start writing and again clap. So I would go back. Another piece of sweets fell down. Clean it, otherwise ants would come. So again I killed. Cleaned and then she said, go, write that important letter. So I went and I was writing 2 minutes after 2 minutes clap and I went again. But this time when I was cleaning, I was just thinking this old man, he's playing mischief. Every 2 minutes, of course, Baba calls me how to write that letter. And Baba says, what are you thinking? I said, nothing. You think that you are doing important work and Gustaji is not doing important work. Now I tell you, Gustaji, why Gustaji is pleased, why he is doing this, do you know? In order to make me please. In order to make me please, he is doing. You are also obeying me, but your obedience does not give me pleasure. Gustaji's obedience gives me pleasure. Why he is doing this? In order to please me, because I feel happy. You also obey, you are writing, but your obedience does not make me pleased. So, obedience also, that should be such that he should feel happy. So this is the difference, that when we obey, always we must remember this, that I must make him happy. I must make him pleased. And why you have sat down in a posture, I know.
15 minutes.
All right. Now I'm talking about this silence and I'm talking. One thing is there. Silence should be so that our wants and desires, attachments, everything, we must make them silent. Otherwise, mind goes on reminding, mind speaks. You are silent, but mind is speaking. So that is not silence. Silence, and that silence which is necessary, that means even if you talk, it does not make any difference. That so long your desires, wants, attachments, everything, they become silent. So that is real silence. Then of course Baba's silence, it is that active silence which will make our desires, wants, attachments, everything silent. Those desires will speak to that extent where you will find that they are useful for you, for progress of your consciousness. And that is real silence. And he observed silence that was the medium of his universal work. In order to make us silent means our desires, wants, just to minimize to great extent so that we may make progress towards the reality. That is the essence of his silence. And he is going, when he has observed silence for this purpose, so why he would not speak? His speaking will be awakening. You will be awakened. And you will know what you should do. Not that you would become silent, but your desires, low desires, they will become silent. They will become silent only those desires which are even low but useful for further progress. So you will have that. But you will not go here and there, you will go straight. You will go straight towards him. So that is his silence, and why Baba observed this silence for this work. So that we also become silent and only keep those impressions which are necessary for the progress of consciousness. We will not just go on intellect. Intellect will be substituted by intuition. Intuition you experience on fifth plane. On fifth plane. So you will not go, everyone will not have fifth plane. But now you get inspiration. Sometimes the poets, the writers, the painters, they get inspiration. How they, inspiration of course it is in second plane of subtle world. Inspiration. How you get that inspiration? Inspiration when there is concentration on certain thing. So you get for the time being the inspiration, you derive inspiration from second plane. And then of course you write well, good painting. It is because of the inspiration. But actually, for the time being you feel, but then of course inspiration not continuously, Inspiration you experience only in second plane. When you remain absorbed, the music of the second plane, subtle world, it is such that you remain so absorbed that you do not want to go further. Because you remain absorbed and it is so blissful that you do not want to go further. You don't know what advancement in this, you remain absorbed in that. And that's why the masters, they also help them. When Baba was contacting all these masts, so he was also giving them further advancement and at the same time the work of the universe. And that's why it was very, very difficult for Baba to give the work to them. They would not take willingly. And Baba would just try to give them this, to just please them. He would give them massage and different things he would do for them. And when they will come in mood, at that time, he would just give that work. He would spend hours with these mad persons. For the world, they are mad, but they are not mad. We are mad. They are sensible persons, very sensible. So Baba's work, now you just see the must work, wayfarers you read, and I said that it is still not complete. So he did the work up to the last, up to 1967. 67, after meeting this second accident, then he would not go on must tour, but the must would be brought to him. He would send Baidul to bring the must. And Baidul was the expert. He did not know which plane are this, he would not know. But he would get some smell and he would just find out the must and he would bring. So this work Baba did, and you must have seen that film. When Baba was in seclusion, he would not come out. But what he did, leper work. So one day he was to come out of his seclusion for leper work. And this Van Gustern, he came all of a sudden. He came. And then Baba allowed him to take film. And not only allowed, but gave private interview under a tree. Did you see that film?
Yes.
Yes. Give interview to him. And that was the last film. Last film taken by Van Gustern. I tried and tried and tried, but I failed miserably. Miserably, I failed. But then, just I would ask him that to just release that film, and he would not do. I went to Paris, and he was called in Paris, but he would take this. And he would talk different things. And talking, and all of a sudden he says to John Connor, "Are you married?" So John Connor says, "No, I was about to get married, but I did not." "Why did not? Why?" He said that accounts, when I check my accounts, my income and her income, so it was not possible for me to just live together. I am now with my parents, so I had not so much money. He said, just send telegram to her, send cable and call her here. And he took 2 hours for that. And John, of course, he was, what to do now? So I have given the name account book to his the would-be wife. That could not account book, and she also tells before others that account book, her name, account book. So then, of course, he did not give anything, and next day it was about 12 midnight. So said, next day I would come, but at what time I should come? I said, tomorrow in the morning our meeting is there, but if you can come at 6 o'clock, then we would discuss. He did come at 6 o'clock. I was very much amazed. I thought that he would not come. He would not be able to come at 6 o'clock. 12 midnight, and he was, that day was that day it was not possible to get the wine. But then, of course, poor Paul Comer went and thus that brought from here and there and gave him, and he was drinking and drinking and drinking. Next day he came at 6 o'clock, and then, of course, I had some discussion, and then afterwards I said that now I'm going to Duno. So you come to Duno. He did come. So what I did, that I arranged some Baba lovers there just to discuss with him. From morning up to 4 o'clock they were discussing, but nothing happened. And they brought that. I said, now what are you going to do? So he said, yes, I will do it. But then, of course, he did not do. And our, what is his name? Seria Press. Andy. What is his real name? Real name? You don't know? Eighth Wonder. What is his real name? He is king of the astral world. He is the king. He is not the king. He is on fourth plane. So fourth plane, of course, I have given that name. I forget now. But I will remember. So that Andy, when he went there, so good food he arranged, and this also he arranged. And I don't know how, of course, he agreed, and that video, of course, he agreed to make, and he did. So 5 minutes, all right. 5 minutes are there. So now, eighth wonder, that in the world there are 7 wonders. Eighth wonder is that who is the first plane. So there are 2 parts. One part is called astral world, or subtle world, or dream world. So he is the king of the dream world. And king of dream world, he can create any dream which is useful to you spiritually.
He dreams a lot.
No, it is a dream means under his control. Only thing that whatever he wants, of course, so that you may make progress, further progress. So it is not that useless dream. Just like you just see Baba in your dream, but you see in such a way that not like a dream, but longing towards him. So he is the king of astral world.
Oh,
Yes. Did you see him? His face?
Yeah, I seen him. I wondered about him.
Yeah. Very good person. Of course, useful dreams. He creates useful dreams in everyone. If you want, you can approach him. Is there any fee for that? Whether you charge? See how honest he is. He does not charge nothing, but he see your face and then he said, all right, go. And then you see the dream and the longing starts. Yes, towards God. That is the dream he sees. He creates that for different persons, different type. Not the same dream. No.
Is that the truth?
Huh?
That's you. That's you.
Yes, he is. But how can you know? But you experience something. And you know what dream he needs. Certain person who approaches you, so you know what type of dream he needs for his upliftment. So that dream you create in him.
Does he do it consciously or unconsciously?
Unconsciously, of course, you have unconsciously, you don't know. But if you approach him, so he gives, but he knows that what is suitable for you, what dream, what type of dream, so that if you see that dream, then of course your love towards, your longing towards Baba. That's why he is the king of astral world.
1 minute.
Yeah. All right, 1 minute. So I finish it here. Tomorrow, of course, I had said that labor phase, new life, I would explain, and another subject came. So, but tomorrow definitely we will not go from here unless labor phase. All right, Jai Baba. Jai Baba.